I am told to say something more about the night school. So I told you I was there for 10 full years and I found how many people were ready to come to the night school. And I asked them, why do you come? The reason was they wanted to get the SSC certificate in order to get better jobs. And they actually did get better jobs. One of them even became principal of a school. Some came even to Europe as managers or I don't know what. But the fact is that they were very, very happy and very, very grateful to the work that we were doing in St. Saviour's. Besides the showing the pictures, I started also with the so-called notice board apostolate. Wherever school I went to, I used to be in charge of the notice boards at the entrance of the school. And then I put very attractive pictures and captions explaining the meaning of the pictures. It was a real sermon in disguise. And I knew that many people took note of those pictures, of the captions, and took them home. So it was an apostolate, the apostolate of the image, which is much more important than the apostolate of the mouth, no, the apostolate. Anyway, I was very happy with that. Then another thing, I found time also to preach retreats. And I preached more than 25 8 days retreat to different types of people, novices in Dindigal, and novices twice in Gujarat, there. And I still they remember my retreat because every day at the end of the retreat, I used to show them also part of the picture of Jesus of Nazareth. And the last day of the retreat, famous Marcelino Pan y Vino. Many still ask me, Father, do you have still that picture? Yes, I have it, but now cannot be shown anymore. So I preach also orientation days. And what the retreat that made a greater impression on me was the one I used to preach in Sofia School, Montabu, to the students of the 10th standard. I gave at least more than 25 different 3 days retreat, and it was a tremendous, very, very impressive for those Christian and non-Christian students. Most of them were non-Christians. So then, when I was actually, I had finished giving one of these retreats in Montabu a few, about 5-6 years ago, I got a brain stroke. I was found in my room. I was at that time chaplain of St. Mary's Montabu, Irish Brothers, and I found myself there lying on the ground without knowing what had happened. After I found that I had had a stroke, and when I went to finish the email I was writing, I found that the fingers of one of my hands were not working. But then I tried with the right hand, and with the index finger, I managed to finish the email, and I sent it to Spain, actually to Father Arroyo, was the one I was writing to. But then, due to the prayers of the students, because all of the students who had made the retreat, non-Christian and Christian alike, when they heard the news that I was in the hospital, in the Brahma Kumaris there, all of them went to the chapel to pray for my recovery, and I did recover. In 1 week, I could again could speak rather fluently, but anyhow, since there were no great many facilities in Abu, they decided to take me here to Baroda. And here I am in Baroda, in Jivan Darshan. Then coming to Baroda, the provincial told me, well, this is providential. You have recovered your speech, so be in charge now of the shrine of our of the Mother of the Forsaken, because the chaplain, the actual chaplain was Arta, Father Arta, but he also had got this brain stroke, and ever since has not been able to say a word. After 8 years, still he cannot express himself. But now, and finally, and I finish with this, last year, it was my last trip to Spain, when I was there, in our school in Pamplona, I found myself once again lying down on the floor of my room. I didn't know what had happened. I could shout, but nobody would answer. I was there at night more than 4 or 5 hours, unable to get help from any. So I thought, this is wonderful. I am going to die in a house of the society without receiving the sacraments. But anyhow, at the end, it was 7:30 in the morning, there appear, I start banging with a stick, different, this, how do you call this, palmeira or whatever it is, no? And finally the one in charge came to my rescue. They put me back in bed after they took me to the clinic, because I was feeling a pain here close to my heart that was not going. So there they, after different analysis, they found out that I was suffering from pneumonia. They tried their best for me to get rid of it. At the beginning they didn't succeed, but finally with good antibiotics I managed to recover, but I had to wait long time before the doctor gave me the green light to come back to India. And people were telling me, but why are you going to go to India now at the age of 88? And it is true. I said, all I am going to have to do here now is what appears in the catalogue in Latin, Orat pro Ecclesia et Societate. He prays for the church and the society. You could do it as well that here in Spain, but nothing doing. I said, no, I want to go back, because I feel after spending most of my time in India, more than 62 years, it is but in the fitness of things that I should die here. And I am waiting for that day that sooner or later will also come to me.